Well, thank you, Chancellor Dirks, for your warm welcome and really a perfect introduction to our evening. It's my pleasure to call to order the 2031st stated meeting of the American Academy of Arts and Sciences. And it's a pleasure to be back at Berkeley, which has 213 current members of the Academy from the Berkeley community. And over time, there have been 437 members of this community, who have been part of the Academy. We're very happy to have welcomed six additional members this last year. From our founding in 1780, the Academy's been a source of independent, trusted advice on important issues. That tradition continues with our recent Commission on Science and Technology, recommending greater federal investment in basic research. We now have underway a project co-chaired by former Berkeley Chancellor Robert Bourgeonneau on the challenges facing public research universities in the face of sharp cuts in funding. Probably that's something that is known and experienced here. And another commission just taking shape that will look at how Americans are obtaining their post-secondary education with a particular attention to cost and fairness of access. Our long-standing concern for global security continues with new studies looking at technology and the ethical questions that think drones that are raised by the use of new technologies in war. And another study just underway on failed states and civil wars around the world and how they affect global security. And we've started a new exploratory fund where any member can write and say, I have an idea I'd like to talk over with other members of the Academy, and we'll organize a meeting at the Academy or at your home campus to talk about issues of interest, current issues, or issues over the horizon that are only dimly perceived but really deserve conversation. And we have our first meeting in November, last November, looking at the really miserable state of legal services for poor people in the United States, where only 20% of poor people entitled to legal services are able to get them, 80% turned away. We have another meeting coming up on the future of jazz, an important art form that has bridged cultures and geography and class and race in our society, but may be losing its way. And yet another study looking at the disconnect between global studies and area studies and wondering how that reconnection can be made. The Academy is making a vigorous effort to engage its members in all of its work, so please do come forward with your ideas. And we are reaching out beyond Cambridge. We now will have 20 meetings around the country this academic year in different locations, and we're beginning to live stream our stated meetings in Cambridge around the country. And we're starting local program committees. And I would love to see a local committee here in Berkeley to organize meetings that may not involve us, but where you can get together and talk about issues of common concern. So volunteers will be welcome during the cocktail hour, I hope. Tonight's program, Consensus and Controversy in Science, Genes, GMOs, and Climate, is one of the Academy's Morton Mandel public lectures and is part of our Morton Mandel program for civic discourse and membership engagement. This program aims to strengthen the bonds of community among the Academy's 4,600 members as we stimulate discussion of important issues, not just among ourselves, but as we reach out as the Academy was intended to do when it was founded in 1780, and really engage the public in discussion of important issues. Our topic this evening bears directly on the new Academy initiative on the public face of science the Chancellor referred to. This three-year project will include an in-depth examination of how individual beliefs and scientific comprehension affect the public's perception of and trust in both science and the scientific process. We'll also work with journalists to examine the role of the media in shaping the public's perception of how scientists work, think, collaborate, and debate. To look at how science informs policy development, we'll undertake a set of case studies on how scientists are consulted during public decision-making, for example, expert witnesses in the legal system, or in responding to natural disasters or public health crises. And so conversations like the one we're about to have and others we're convening across the country will provide both inspiration and guidance about the specific questions that this new initiative should examine and will shape this initiative from the early stages. And so we're really interested in this exploration tonight of the public's views on genetic engineering and climate change, and I think these will be a good, this is the first really major meeting we've had as this initiative gets underway. So I'm grateful to Professor Schuckman and Davna Miller and Ronald for the insights they're about to share with us. And it's now my pleasure to introduce Randy Schuckman, who will then present tonight's panel and moderate the discussion. Randy is ideally suited for this role, given his remarkable record of leadership in research, publishing, and science policy. The bio is in his in the program, so I won't read all the honors, but I will note that he served as editor-in-chief of the Proceedings of the National Academy of Sciences, and more recently of the open access journal eLife. He's been deeply engaged with this academy, the American Academy, having served on our council and on our Committee on Advancing Research in Science and Engineering, which called for a greater investment in early career investigators and investment in high-risk, high-reward research. So, Randy, take it away.